Hello, and thank you for inviting me to be part of the International Yoga and Health Expo video presentations. It is an honor for me to spread the word about peace and love and inspire you to integrate the values of this visionary initiative into your lifestyle. So what are the values? The values are to bring awareness about vegan and vegetarian eating habit, yoga and yogic lifestyle, meditation, organic food production and consumption, and how our lifestyle make an impact on the environment. Today, July 28th, is the World Nature Conservation Day. Recognizes that a healthy environment is the foundation for a stable and productive society. Protect, conserve and sustainably manage our natural resources. What are our natural resources? They are water, air, soil, minerals, trees, animals, food, and fuel for our transportation to live our daily lives. Scientists warning us that the natural world is facing an increased threat from unsustainable practices, and the challenge is how to preserve and conserve nature in the process of achieving sustainable development. July 28th, on this day, I invite you to make a conscious effort to contribute to the local, national, and global efforts conserving nature. Let us look at closer what are these three words mean. First is, what does protect mean? It means to care for or to look after. What does conserve means? It means do not take much more or do not take more than what you need, or simply just take what is necessary for your living. And the third one is, what does sustainable managed means? It is a practice of combination of protect and conserve. All life, including Mother Earth, all animals, plants, and humankind. Let us discuss in more details the resources and what can we do to protect and conserve them. Out of the eight of them, we will discuss three, which is air, water, and soil. So let us start with air. Human beings and most animals can survive without air about 60 seconds. That shows the importance of air and preferable clean air. Last decades, we have seen serious air pollution problems everywhere on the planet, particularly large cities like Beijing, Mexico City, or LA. So what are the main sources of air pollution? The main sources are extensive burning of fossil fuels, beef industry, including cutting down the rainforest, and increasing frequency of sandstorms, which is the result of the rising temperature of the planet. In the recent lockdown due to COVID-19 pandemic, lack of traffic and reduced industry helped to clear the air. For example, in northern India, people were able to see the Himalayas for the first time in decades. That shows that we can contribute to clean air. Number one is reducing fossil fuel burning. Number two, reducing beef consumption. Number three, stop cutting the rainforest. And number four is plant more trees. June 2nd is dedicated to Canada Clean Air Day as a part of the Canadian Environment Week to protect and celebrate our nature. For more information, please visit canada.ca. The second resource is our water. Human beings can survive without water is about 3 to 5 days. This shows the importance of water, and it must be without pollution and poisonous elements. Very sad to see the picture where corporations reluctantly let their waste to poison rivers and oceans. This happens out of lack of awareness and lack of caring. Pacific Institute, a non-profit organization in Oakland, California, has an excellent website which provides information about water conditions and the solutions to the problems. So please visit pacificinstitute.org. And the last one is the soil. Why is it important to have good quality soil? Our vegetables and fruits are produced on the soil. So the quality of the food depends on the mineral content of the soil and the quality of the water. Prevention of soil erosion is a whole topic what you can learn about on the website of the United Nations. United Nations declared December 5th World Soil Day. This concludes my presentation, and I trust that you have learned one thing what you can change and incorporate into your daily life. For example, carpooling to reduce fossil fuel burning, or choosing a vegetarian diet once a week. This small contribution can make a big difference to build a better and brighter 21st century. Bye for now and see you soon.